Hello there, everybody. Hi, I'm Jo. I'm your teacher today. I can see lots of familiar names already there in the chat. Really nice to see you. Welcome to everybody. If you haven't joined us before, then welcome. Let us know in the chat where you are. Where are you in the world? We like to see all the different countries where people are joining us from. I've seen lots already. Algeria, Hungary. Hi, Julia. Welcome back. Hi to you. Masab in Egypt, Raphael in Portugal, Mariam in Tunisia. I'm in France. Did I say that? I'm not sure. Okay, Ong from Myanmar. Hello, Algeria. Hello from DRC, Hungary. I can see Palestine, Lebanon, Mexico City, Philippines, Colombia. Wow, lots of different places as usual. Hello, hi to you, Lebanon, India, Morocco. Wow, welcome to everybody. Don't forget that to join in as much as you can with us in the chat. We love reading your comments. So while people are still joining, then perhaps we can tell you a little bit more about what we're going to do in today's session. So today's session, introduction, parrots. Actually, it's going to be pirates and parrots. Sounds a bit strange, but you'll understand a bit more in a moment. Our grammar today is avoiding repetition. We'll have a quiz, and then it will be your turn to practice. Actually, the quiz is going to come at the end, so I hope that you'll stick around for that later on. Okay, so lots of people joining us. Great to have you with us. As I said, join in as much as you can. We like to see as many comments as possible there in the chat. Okay, so let's get started with today's topic. So today we've got quite a funny special day happening today. Maybe some of you have seen about it on social media. When I opened my computer today, there was a big notification that told me it's a special day today. And the special day is Talk Like a Pirate Day. Have any of you heard about it? Have you heard about this special day? Have you seen it at all on social media? A bit of a just a funny one, really, like a fun one. And so, what do you think that people do on this special day? What do people do on Talk Like a Pirate Day? I'm not even really sure myself. So if anybody can tell me more about what people do. But have you seen any films or read any books with pirates in them? And what did you notice about how they speak? Okay, so pirates, they tend to make really good characters, I think, in films and books. So, Valerie, shiver me timbers. Oh, you're already talking like a pirate. I love it. Excellent. Okay, anybody seen any films or read any books with pirates in them? And did you notice anything about how they speak? Gayathri, hello. Peter Pan, good answer. Yes, exactly. Peter Pan, the pirate in that, if I remember rightly, was Captain Hook. April Moon, Pirates of the Caribbean. Yes, exactly. I've seen that one. Has many of you seen Pirates of the Caribbean? Films, of course, Pirates of the Caribbean. Yes, I think it's quite a popular one, isn't it? Oh, they repeated the chants. Yes, exactly. So they have these special pirate chants or some of the kind of songs that they sing, and they have lots of different expressions as well. Okay, so they're not orthodox. Okay, so you mean they talk in a kind of a special, a different sort of a way. Okay, I can see lots of people have seen Pirates of the Caribbean. And somebody says Jack Sparrow, good, yes. Treasure Island, exactly. Yeah, that's a classic novel with pirates. Treasure Island. Has anybody else read that? I can see April Moon's a fan of Captain Jack Sparrow. Yeah, he's a really good character, isn't he? So I think that he makes the film really interesting. Gayathri, oh, Captain, yes, good. Okay, so some of you I can see already know some pirate expressions. We've got a little video. It's just a little homemade video for you, with some pirate expressions. So have a look at the video and tell me maybe if you know some of them already. Some of you have already said them, and or are some of them new for you?
Shiver me timbers! Ahoy there, me hearties! Yo ho ho! Aye aye, Captain! Shiver me timbers!
There we go. So there was a not such a scary pirate there, I think. But how did you recognize any of the expressions that he said? It's even taught in your school, Nadia. Okay, so you've even been talking about pirates in school. Okay, excellent. A beard red, yeah, I think a red beard, a red beard. Yeah, good, excellent. Okay. Somebody's saying they're bad reputation people. Yeah, exactly. Pirates have a bad reputation. Yo ho ho, some people are saying, or I. Yeah, good. Alice in Wonderland. Ah, were there pirates in Alice in Wonderland? I don't remember that, but probably. Julia, Pirates of the Caribbean is a thrilling and gripping movie. Excellent. Have you seen all of the parts, Julia? I think there's several parts to it. Okay, lots of people seem to have seen, and somebody says loud makeup. Yeah, they have lots of makeup there in Pirates of the Caribbean. Okay, so we watched the little video there with the pirates' expressions, and stay with us until later on because we're going to have a quiz on those expressions to see if you remember them and just to check that we know exactly what they mean. Okay, so we've been talking about pirates. So now what I want to ask you is when you think of pirates, what other things do you think of? What things do you associate with pirates? So we've said about the way that they talk. And I think we've even got a link there for you in the chat about pirates' slang words. So slang, that means familiar words, not polite words. So have a look at some of those links later on. What do you associate? That means what do you think of, which are related to pirates? So think of back to those pirate films, those pirate characters. Okay, a trichome. Okay, yeah, good. What else have we got? What else do you associate with pirates? An eye patch, says Marion. Yes, exactly. Good. I think that pirate there is wearing an eye patch. A parrot, says Ong, and a ship. Yeah, good. What else can we see? A few people are saying robbery. Exactly. They are robbers. The ocean, swords and guns, of course, they're weapons. Yes, the pirate hat. Yeah, good. Somebody there says chunky jewelry and dramatic outfits. Absolutely. Yeah. A broken leg. Okay, yeah, because they got into a lot of fights. A pirate on his arm, or maybe on his shoulder. Yeah, good. Ah, here we've got a picture. Let's see which of these we've already talked about. We've talked about the parrot. We've talked about the eye patch. The black flag with the skull. Yeah, good, Alan. That pirate flag, it's got a special name. Does anybody know what that is? The special name? The skull flag, or it's what could we call it? It's got actually two things that I could think of how we could call that flag. A ship. Yep, we've had that. Gold coins. Yes, exactly. Somebody else has said treasure. Yep, the parrot. Good. One less leg, exactly. Yes. So that's because they've been in so many fights. The compass, yes, good, Guthrie. So that's that helps them to navigate on the seas, the map. The map with the X. What is the X showing on the map? Avrazina, yes, you're close with the flag. A jolly something. I'll give you a clue. It's a name, a man's name. A jolly something. See, I'll tell you in a moment. I think somebody's got it there in the chat. April's got it. A map with treasure. Good. So the X marks the spot for the buried treasure. The telescope, plundering. That's a good word. A good word for robbing. April Moon, the Jolly Roger. Exactly. That's it. So on the flag, you've got the skull and the crossbones. And the name we can give to that flag is a Jolly Roger. Not sure why it's called that. A leg made of wood. Yeah, we could call it a wooden leg. A wooden leg. The Jolly Roger is the black flag of piracy. A barrel, somebody said. Yes, good. They had barrels on their ships. I think we've got everything that's on the picture. Maybe the anchor. Can you see that? The anchor, which is in the back. Yes, somebody's just got that. The anchor, that was the beach. Of course, yeah. The anchor, good. Parrots, absolutely. Okay, so the parrot there is in the middle of the picture. And I think that when I think of pirates, that's really one of the main things that I think of is the parrot. Okay, so the parrot on the pirate's shoulder. So the pirates must have thought that parrots made good pets back in those days. And I think people still have parrots as pets now. Maybe you have. Has anybody got a pet parrot? But let's have a little look now. We're going to watch a video of somebody with their pet parrot. And I'd like you to tell me, what is the parrot doing? Okay, so we're going to watch a little video, and can you tell me what is the parrot doing in the video?
What's this called? What's this called?
Block.
What's this called?
Sock.
What's this made of?
Rock.
What's this called?
Rock.
No.
Rock.
No.
This is a block.
Can you tell me what's this made of?
Glass.
Yeah, what's this called?
Snack.
You want to earn a snack? Okay. What's this called?
It's a bell.
What's this made of?
Paper.
What's this called?
Block.
No. Ball.
This is a ball.
It's a ball. That was really close. Good job. What's this made of?
Rock.
What's this bell made of?
Metal.
Yes, made of metal. Good boy. And a snack.
Okay, good. I thought that that parrot was really good, really clever. And some of you have got good answers here in the chat to our question, what's the parrot doing? Eating. Yes, so it got a treat when and something to eat when it got the right answer. Hannah, studying vocabulary. Yes, good. Okay, so the parrot was learning words. Maria, the parrot is speaking. Yeah, super. It's a smart parrot. Yes, exactly. The parrot is imitating the words, or he can spy for a new land. Okay, the parrot is imitating words. Good. Learning vocabulary. Yes. Talking or imitating. Right. Okay, so imitating, copying the its owner. That parrot speaks better English than me. Okay, but I think the parrot maybe just could use one word or a very simple phrase. Mimicking, yes, good. So mimicking, that means copying, repeating and getting food, yes. All good answers here, good, yeah. Following instructions, the parrot is learning. The parrot is articulate, yeah, good. It's discovering the material of things. Okay, super, distinguishing different things. So a lot of you said it's imitating. And some of you said it's repeating or it's copying. Okay, so this is all part of how parrots speak. So somebody said he's guessing. So I think it's probably trying to remember what its owner, what it has taught the parrot. Okay, because it copies. Okay, so we've got a little text for you to look at to do with parrots and what kind of pets they make and how they speak. Okay, so I'm going to read this text to you, and can you tell me what do you think the problem could be with the text? Is there a problem with it, and how could we improve it? So parrots are popular pets in many countries. Parrots are very intelligent. Parrots are sociable birds with an ability to mimic human speech. The ability to mimic human speech is found in parrots and a few other birds. So what's the problem with the text, and how can we improve it? So while you're thinking about that, I've just seen a really interesting comment that somebody has an African grey parrot. Excellent, Oscar. I have an African grey parrot, and she can say good morning in the morning and hello when we open the gate. Wow, really clever. Okay, so you will confirm for us then probably that parrots are very intelligent and they make good pets. So what's the problem then? Is there a problem with this text, and how could we improve it? So I can see people are getting the right answer here in the comments. Good. Repetition in all the text. Yes, repetition. Another person there saying repetition. You could replace parrots with they. Yeah, okay. Repetition or repetitive. You could say the text is too repetitive. Some of the words are repeated too many times. Good, Nicoletta. Parrots and the ability to mimic human speech are repeated, and they can be replaced. Yes. Okay, so you've got it. Too much repetition. Why don't we want too much repetition? It might be okay for parrots. That's pretty clever if they can repeat words. But for human beings, sometimes when we repeat too much, what happens? Why do we not want to repeat too much sometimes in a text? Why is it not good to be too repetitive? Repeating words like parrots, yeah, make it sound like a parrot. I have a yellow and white one, and she copies eye movements, right? Okay, so they can mimic movements as well as a speech. Okay, so why is it not good to repeat too much? Somebody has said that it can make the audience feel bored. Yeah, getting bored. It's boring, right? So we don't want to repeat ourselves. Oh, somebody had something good there. I didn't have time to read that. The text becomes The text becomes monotonous to read with repetitions. Exactly, monotonous. It's just a little bit boring. Exactly. Okay, boring repetition. Yes. Our speeches would be long. Right, so if we can replace some of these words instead of repeating them, it can make our texts not too long and can make them more interesting. And it will stop us sounding like parrots. Okay, so how could we change this then? Some people have given us some good suggestions. So parrots are popular pets in many countries. They are intelligent, sociable birds with an ability to mimic human speech. This ability is found in parrots and a few other birds. Okay, so at the beginning we had parrots, parrots, parrots. Do you remember three times? So there we've replaced one of them with they, and then we've kind of just taken one out completely and we've made it all into one sentence. So they are very intelligent, comma, sociable birds. And then the ability to mimic human speech, we can say this ability because we've already mentioned it. So we're just going back to something we've already mentioned. Okay, is it much better now? Somebody said, yeah, I agree. I think that reads much better than the first text. Good, Lewis agrees it's better. Okay, so let's take a little bit of a closer look now at what we can do to avoid repetition. So it, they, this or these, and that or those can all be used to refer to something that has just been mentioned or that has been mentioned previously. So that's what we've just been doing. Let's have a look at an example. We watched a documentary about parrots last night. It was really interesting. They make great pets. Okay, so we don't have to repeat ourselves there. It, well, we already mentioned the documentary, and they, we've already mentioned the parrots. So there we go. We've made it shorter and more interesting and not boring. Another example. This ability is found in parrots and a few other birds. That was the example we had just a few minutes ago. And the sounds produced by parrots aren't as varied as those produced by humans. So those, plural there, it's going back to the sounds that we've already mentioned. Okay, let's look in a bit more detail. So it and they are used to refer to something with no particular emphasis. But this, singular, or these, plural, is more emphatic. So by that we mean we're giving it emphasis, we're giving more like more force or more importance to it. So this or these is more emphatic and shows that something is new or interesting. This often signals that more is about to be said about the topic. Now you see we've used it there, this, so the fact that this or these is more emphatic. So this often signals that more is about to be said about the topic. So let's have a look at some more examples. Parrots are very talented mimics. We had that word before, didn't we? A mimic, somebody who can copy. The fact that they are talented mimics doesn't mean that they can have actual conversations with humans. Okay, so that's super long and just sounds a bit boring. So let's take out the fact that they are talented mimics the second time and replace it with this. Much shorter, and we know that we are referring back to what we've just said. So this doesn't mean that they can have actual conversations with humans. Much easier. Okay, that or those is used in a similar way to this. That or those can refer to an idea mentioned further back in the text. Okay, so it doesn't have to be the thing we've just mentioned. It can be going further back to talk about something that we've mentioned before. So parrots are known for their ability to mimic human speech. In fact, some parrots can learn to say hundreds of words or phrases. And then in the next paragraph, those that are trained to speak often become very popular pets. Okay, so even in the next paragraph, we don't have to say some parrots that are trained to speak. We can just say those because we already know what we're talking about. We remember that we've already referred to some parrots. Okay, let's now do a little bit of practice. So some people are saying simple. Okay, so this, that, these, and those, of course, they're simple words, aren't they? But we just have to remember exactly when we can use them in this way to avoid repetition and make our text seem more interesting. Okay, so let's see. Your turn now. Your turn to practice. So first of all, I'm going to read you a sentence with repetition. And then underneath, you can see the sentence which needs to be completed with a little word that's going to improve our sentence. Okay, so number one, parrots are intelligent, sociable birds with an ability to mimic human speech. Parrots are popular pets in many countries. So what can we put here? Number one, how can we replace the second parrots? They, those, okay, some people are saying they or those. So obviously we know that they are plural. So we've got lots of different answers here. Those, they, okay. Lots of people are saying they. I think here, they are popular pets. Here, I don't think we want to put really much specific emphasis. I think here we're just continuing just this idea that parrots are intelligent, sociable birds. So what do we think here? What could be just the best possibility to put here? Lots of people are saying they. What do we think? I think that's the best one we could put here. Parrots are intelligent, sociable birds with an ability to mimic human speech. They are popular pets in many countries. Okay, really simple there. That's just a simple one to start with. We just need to replace parrots with they. Okay, let's have a look at this one now. Number two, can we compare a parrot's speaking ability to the speaking ability of a human? Okay, there we've got too much repetition. What could we put there for number two? Can we compare a parrot's speaking ability to of a human? What could we put there? So we're talking about the speaking ability. That's what we want to, that's what we want to replace. They, maybe you're answering the previous one there. That. Okay, so remember the speaking ability, think about, is it singular or plural? That. Okay, so it's something which has already been mentioned. April Moon says that. Yes. Okay, lots of people are saying that. To that of a human. Good. Okay. To this of a human. To that. Okay, I think most people are saying that. What do we think is the best option here? Can we compare a parrot's speaking ability to that of a human? Yeah, I think that's the best one there. So we're just going, referring back to what has just been said, the speaking ability to that of a human. Okay, doing well. Number three, some parrots can produce a lot of words, but the fact they can produce a lot of words doesn't mean they understand everything they are saying. So what could we put there to complete the sentence to replace the fact they can produce a lot of words? Because that's just way too long. Some parrots can produce a lot of words, but doesn't mean that they understand everything they are saying. Okay, so I can see it, this, that, this, this. Yeah, it. Quite a lot of people are saying, but this doesn't mean, yeah, that, says Emily. This, okay, lots of people are saying this or that or it. Okay, what do we think is the best answer here? Azara says those. Okay, let's think it's just going to be singular because it's the fact, a singular fact. So let's take something singular for this. This, okay, good. But this doesn't mean, okay, what do we think is the best option here? Okay, this or that? I'd say it could be either, really. We said that they're used really similarly. So here we could say, some parrots can produce a lot of words, but this doesn't mean, or but that doesn't mean. I think that's better there than it. Wouldn't be grammatically incorrect, but it doesn't mean. That's okay grammar-wise. But I think that we want to be, you know, we use the word emphatic. We want to add emphasis here. We want to make it a little bit more more forceful. So some parrots can produce a lot of words, but that doesn't mean. Okay, I like that a bit better than it in this one, although it, we could argue, is could be correct as well. Have we got a last one? Yes. Okay. The sounds produced by parrots aren't as varied as the sounds produced by humans. Okay, so we want to replace the sounds because we don't want to repeat it. in the sentence. So what could we use there to repeat, and not to repeat, to replace the sounds? The sounds produced by parrots aren't as varied as produced by humans. Aline, those. Okay, good. Those. As those produced by humans. Good. Okay, so we're getting here that the sounds, that's plural. The ones, somebody said. Yeah, that's good. Those. Those. Lots and lots of people are saying those. The sounds produced by parrots aren't as varied as produced by humans. Full of those. Okay. So what's the best option here? Those. Yeah, the sounds produced by parrots aren't as varied as those. And those, some people have said the ones, and that's exactly, they mean the same thing. That's what we want to say with those, as the ones, as those. In that, maybe those sounds a little bit more more formal, perhaps. Okay, but good. So we're talking, what the main thing to remember is we are using those to refer back to something which has already been mentioned. Okay, there's lots of other ways of avoiding repetition in a text. And you might like to practice this, read another explanation, which is maybe a little bit longer, and do some more practice. So we've just put a link here in the comments to the Learn English website. So you can read more there. So let's have another look now at that, all of those together, just to double check the answers. Parrots are intelligent, sociable birds with an ability to mimic human speech. They are popular pets in many countries. Can we compare a parrot's speaking ability to that of a human? Some parrots can produce a fairly wide range of words, but this, or but that, doesn't mean that they understand everything they are saying. The sounds produced by parrots aren't as varied as those produced by humans. Okay, so that's just, you know, a very short explanation of how to use this, that, these and those, it and they, to avoid repetition. And as I said, don't hesitate to go onto the Learn English website and do some more practice. Okay, I think we've been talking quite a lot about parrots. Let's go back to the pirates. Let's go back to the pirate that we saw at the beginning. If you've joined us, since we were talking about pirates, we watched a small video of a pirate saying some typical pirate expressions, you know, like you might see in a pirate film or read in a pirate book. So I wonder if we can show the video for you again for people who didn't see it the first time.
Yo ho ho! Aye aye, Captain! Is yo ho ho! Aye aye, Captain!
Okay, there were a few that we didn't see again, but never mind, that's fine. We will just have a look at the quiz and have a look at the pirate expressions. Okay, so the pirate is as talkative as the parrot, says Ong. Yeah, exactly. Okay, time for a quiz. So let's see, do you know how to talk like a pirate? Do you know some of these pirate expressions? So in the comments, put your answers. Is it A, B or C? So which of these pirate phrases means hello, friends? So is it A, ahoy me hearties? Is it B, shiver me timbers? Or is it C, aye aye, captain? Which one do you think it is? Which one means hello, friends? Rosina says A, ahoy me hearties. A, okay, we've got agreement here. A from Gayathri. Maria thinks it's C, aye aye, captain. Okay. C, says Hania. Okay, we've got a bit of a mix here. B, shiver me timbers, says April. A, Nicoletta. Okay, so some people are saying A, some people are saying C. Ahoy, me hearties. Hello, friends. Yes. What do you think? A, what's the correct answer here? Which phrase means hello, friends, in pirate talk? What is the correct answer? Ahoy, me hearties. So, ahoy, that's things that people, pirates and people on ships, I think, say hello. And me hearty, so heart, that would be like people, I suppose, people close to your heart. So they could be your friends, or probably for the pirates, it would be the people in their crew, the other pirates in the crew. Ahoy, me hearty. So if you hear that, you know that that's a way that one pirate greets other pirates. Okay, so now which phrase is used as an expression of fear? So if a pirate is afraid, which one of these phrases or expressions could they use? A, ahoy me hearties. B, yo ho ho. Or C, shiver me timbers. Maria says, I'm speechless. Okay. Okay. We've got some answers here. Which one is used as an expression of fear? Which one would a pirate use if they were afraid? Okay, lots of people saying C, shiver me timbers. C. Yeah, this is one, I think, probably the most well-known pirate expression. It's the one I probably would think of most. Shiver me timbers. Okay, lots of agreement here on shiver me timbers. Yeah, shiver me timbers, C. Correct answer. Okay, so when you shiver, I suppose you shiver when you are afraid. And the timbers, so timber can mean wood. And because the pirate ships were made of wood, I suppose that was what they were referring to there. Okay, last one. Which phrase is used to say yes? Is it ahoy me hearties, yo ho ho, or aye aye captain? Which one is used to say yes? What do you think there? Is it yo ho ho or C? Aye, aye, captain. C, Tasmina. Okay. Aye, aye, captain. Yep, that's C. B. B. C. Okay. Lots of people are saying C or B. Lots of C's. Aye, aye, captain, says Raphael. Okay, what's the correct answer here? Yeah, aye, aye. So aye, aye, that means yes. And so the captain is like the boss of the ship. So if they're saying yes to their boss, aye, aye, captain. So perhaps the captain's giving them some orders. Yo, ho, ho. Does anybody know what that one means? I'm not sure. I think it's just probably just a general pirate greeting or an expression, a piratey expression that they use in lots of different situations. Okay, so as I said at the beginning, today's Talk Like a Pirate Day. You've got a few expressions now if you feel like talking like a pirate today. And I hope that the grammar lesson about avoiding repetition has been useful for you. Anyway, oh, yo-ho-ho and a bottle of rum. Exactly, that was what the pirates say. Good. Okay, yo-ho-ho is greetings. Okay, so that's been really fun reading your comments today. As usual, thank you for coming and joining us. We'll be back again this time next week for another live grammar lesson. And so in the meantime, have a good week and thank you for coming. Aye, aye, Teacher Joan.